Hello everyone, Gritz here. Well, was doing a little bit of research in this last time, and come to find out that the world I had created was basically perverse. Everything was set way too high. Bottom line, I'm a noob at this game, and it was just too much game for me to handle. So I went ahead and adjusted the settings, created a new world. I think I might have gotten the all of the variables set to something that is more my speed, and let's go ahead and see what happens. Okay, so looks like we're starting on the edge of the snow biome. So I do know that I have not had much luck in the snow biome, so let's go ahead and head out of here and see what we can see. Oh, for Pete's sake, we're doing this again? What does that mean? Is that a edge of a town or edge border maybe? Okay, looks like we don't have much of a choice but to stay in the snow biome. Move through it. So far, it just looks like miscellaneous stuffs. Okay, so we got some pretty good loot right off the bat. There's a structure off to our right there, which will probably have a lot of zombies hanging out. Still early enough in the day, we might be able to work with it. What is that? Is that a rock? No, it's a backpack. Okay, so let's go ahead and gather some materials. Sorry, guys, I just got a tickle in my throat. Thought I was gonna cough to death. Okay, so we should be able to make a club. Go ahead and do that. Okay, we are definitely cold. So let's see if we can't go over there and maybe get indoors. Okay, our first zombies of the new configuration. Let's see if we can't get these guys lined up in such a way that we can defend ourselves. Stunned. Looks like we might be dealing with a little bit of frostbite here.
Okay. looks like these guys are going to tear this place apart for us. Sure, opening this door is a good idea, but we will just have to see. So we got at least three in there, and this guy has decided that he wanted to move to the other door because this door was hitting him too much. So before we break through this, let's go ahead and make another club, which we don't have the wood for. So let's back off for a minute. And gather a little bit more wood. Get another wooden club started. This club has 34 durability left. We'll go ahead and get this club in our bar and see if we can't get back to that building before we freeze to death. Our stamina is definitely low because of the cold. And the cold got us at the same time we got rid of the zombies. I love how over here on the side they had to say Gritz died like 7 times just to rub it in. Okay, so I hope this is not another map making series of episodes. We are. Let's see, our backpack is right there. And. Let's see, center on the player. And we'll come out of this. So our backpack is that direction. And I say we just head off in that direction. See if we can't get there. Going through a burning biome. It is noon. This is a very intense game. Does look like we also have quite a ways to travel. At least we're out of the burning biome now. We're currently undetected, so let's take a look. We are moving north. Yeah, and we have quite a ways to get there. If we can get there before night, then we might be able to get ourselves secured in there. Looks like we've run into that big lake again. So we'll follow this around, and then at least we're still heading in the correct direction. Okay, we are undetected. Let's take another look. Okay. I said we just keep on running. That sounds awfully close. Don't turn around. Okay, we are currently undetected, and we are getting close to our backpack. And it is 3 o'clock in the afternoon. I'm going to say while we are currently undetected, it's probably a good time to collect some materials. Because we're going to want something to do once we hold ourselves up into that market or whatever that was. Gotta tell you guys, it's a tough game. It's fun, if you don't mind dying. The other thing is we need to make some way to store things and make a sleeping bag. So that we're not spawning all over the place. Now, we've got some interesting things around here real quick. We are hunted, so we don't want to stick around too long. Looks like we have quite a few buildings here. So, we're definitely going to want to come back and investigate this area. Once we've collected our backpack and gotten ourselves secure. Okay, we're undetected again. Wood, we got some plant fiber, a few rocks. Collect some more lumber. Probably just over that rise. Our athletics is now level 2. That can't hurt. Okay, looks like we've come up to another small lake or something. So we know we have some drinking water. We have a zombie across the other side. So we just have to enter the snow biome, and we are almost there. This is the closest we've ever been to our backpack. I just hope we don't run off a cliff. Okay, so we are back at the mall or shop or whatever this is. It's almost 6 o'clock at night. We have a fresh club. Looks like that zombie despawned right then. That is a big boy. We are stunned. That is not doing us any favors. What happened? No! Just when we thought we got there. Wow. Okay. So. I think we like the new settings. We're definitely able to get back to our backpack. Which means our new backpack has everything else that we had gotten into it. So, let's go ahead and see where the map is going to put us this time. So we are in a desert. And let's see, we had that waypoint. Okay, let's do it this way. Let's look at the spinner on top. And everything is that way, almost due north. Okay. So, wow. We got further to travel than we did last time. And we got less time to do it in. We had almost a whole day. Being in the desert, we're not going to have a lot for trees. So, not exactly sure how we're going to hide for the night. We did use the same map, so that over there is that junkyard that we know had several dogs in it. I believe they spawn there all the time. That's a good start. The problem is we're going to lose our backpack in favor for this backpack. And I gotta be honest, guys, I would much rather have the other backpack. Based off of the fact that these zombies are still pretty tough. I'm wondering if I haven't quite got the settings down yet. So I guess we can head off in this direction and see if we can't find a place to hide on the way. Now that is a good score. We can use that for both trees if we ever get out of the desert, and we can also use it for attack. 2.7. Wait a second. 2.7 versus, no, the club is still better. And the club still has a durability of 65. But we could use that to help us get into a building faster, perhaps. Now, it looks like we got a campsite here with at least two zombies. Oh, nice. Critical hit. Okay, so, it is getting dark. And, did we clear out this campsite? Okay, we got a sleeping bag. That's good. Okay, let's see what we can do here. did that give us? Nothing. So the question is, can we hold here and not be detected? Now we do have some rotten flesh. I'm not sure why we have that, but it doesn't say we're stinky, so that's fine. We have a wooden club. We have a barbed club. That gives us much significant damage. Words. Why are we dealing with words this time of night? That gives us much more damage. We have a red shirt. We can go ahead and wear that. Okay. And we got two sleeping bags right away. Now the question becomes, do we want to use those? Let's see, what else? Can we make a bow? We need more plant fiber. And then, crossbow. How about, arrows? We need stone and feather. So, we're still pretty far away from a bow and arrow. Why don't we take some time, listen to some fast forward music, and see if we survive the night. Alright everyone, looks like we survived our first day with the new settings. We got a zombie coming in on us, but it shouldn't be a big deal to dispatch him. So, in the next episode, we will go ahead and take a better look around and see if we can't head back into that area we liked. See if we, just make another attempt, grab our backpack, and see if we can't fortify that area. So, until next episode, be safe.